Hello everyone, welcome to Life Around Science, and today's video is about what should you go for, MSc or integrated PhD. This is not exactly a video, but you can listen to this as a podcast. A couple of you had asked to make a video on this in the comment section, and since I have gone through this decision myself in my third year of BSc, I thought I can share some of the points. When I was in my BSc, I had been selected for integrated PhD course at a couple of universities like ISER Pune, TFR Mumbai, ICTS Bangalore. I had also been selected for MSc at IIT Mumbai. And it was quite some time that I had to give to figure out which one is the right, would be the right option for me to go ahead with. I had thought about this from many different angles before coming to the conclusion of going to IIT Bombay for MSc. Also, many people in general ask me why I chose MSc over other integrated PhDs, and I think at the end of this video you'd find out what are the different points that one can think of, and also why I chose MSc at IIT Bombay over others. This particular video would be useful to those people who are thinking where they should apply and whether they should go for an MSc or target for an integrated PhD. I hope it helps them make a decision. In this video, I'll be actually just listing out different points, but at the same time, I will also be telling what I feel about those points, because this is also a video that answers why I took MSc. So I don't mean to bias anyone's opinion. Everyone would have different weights attached to different points and they should think accordingly. So let's get started. The first point, which is the most obvious point, is the duration of the program. The duration of MSc course is 2 years, while that of an integrated PhD is 6 years. This might and might not be an important aspect, but it depends on the person. Depends on how much you want to fix your future. So in MSc, you are fixing the next 2 years of your life, and in integrated PhD, you're kind of fixing the next 6 years. There are a few subpoints which are corollary of this point. So let's go through them. First is change of places. This is not a very important one from career point of view. If you're a person who likes to travel different places, then in MSc plus PhD, you get to live, by the end of your PhD, you get to live at two different places, while in integrated PhD, you are just going to one institute. The next is flexibility. In MSc plus PhD, you get an additional flexibility at the end of your MSc. During your MSc, you get to explore different things, and you can choose what you like at the end of MSc, and you can change your institute if you don't like your current institute. So that's an additional flexibility which you don't get in integrated PhD. So there is an option of changing institute after 2 years. Another one is flexibility from career point of view. In MSc, you will get to try out different things and check if you really want to get into research field. So at the end of MSc, you get a chance to completely change your career path, like doing an MBA or doing something else, like getting into commercial background, doing a startup, or even you can get placed. There are institute placements in IIT, and you can take a job and start earning after MSc, which is difficult in integrated PhD, because even integrated PhD, most of the integrated PhDs offer you a chance to leave the institute with an MSc, but that is in 3 years, and it is not a very mainstream process. So it is not a very easy process, and you have to face some kind of resistance while opting out of the institute with an MSc in 3 years. Another great subpoint is you still have the option of going abroad for a PhD open if you're doing an MSc. So at the end of MSc, after 2 years, you can always choose to apply abroad. This point of flexibility was one of the crucial points when I was making a decision, because I was not 100% sure whether I would like to continue in the same stream ahead, and I would like to enjoy this option of being able to change fields if I don't find it interesting ahead. So basically, I get 2 more years to make the correct decision. So let's go to the next point, which was also crucial for me, and that is that MSc is more education oriented and integrated PhD is more research oriented. What I mean by that is MSc is of 2 years. You go in, you are meant to study for 2 years, take knowledge and leave the institute, which is not the case in integrated PhD. You're supposed to join the institute, you are supposed to study a bit and you are supposed to start working and do research. And that was important for me because I was looking for a place where I would get to solidify my theory. So MSc is a place where I get 2 full years to just concentrate on studies, doing more theory, solidifying my concepts, getting to explore different fields and forming a concrete base. A natural result of this point is our next point, which says that in MSc, you get to explore more fields. So that is the purpose of MSc, right? You have gone there for education and to gain knowledge. So in MSc, you enjoy a lot of electives. You can take as many electives as possible. I ended up taking more than the credit requirements. I took additional courses and I could explore so many fields like advanced particle physics, general relativity, group theory, nonlinear theory, advanced simulation, and many more. So this is what I was looking for. I wanted to dedicate the next 2 years of my life just exploring different fields of physics because there are so many fields and I happen to like most of the physics fields. So that is the advantage that you enjoy in MSc. Whereas in integrated PhD, since it is research oriented, many times, for example, in TIFR, Mumbai, right when you join in an integrated PhD program, you're supposed to choose a department where you will be continuing your work in for the next 6 years. Or for example, in ICER Pune, when you join for integrated PhD, you are allotted a guide in the first few weeks. So the area of research would naturally be the one that your guide is in. And then you are basically supposed to take those courses which guide recommends you. So naturally, those are the ones that will help you in your research work ahead. So it's not very restrictive. You can still take other electives during your coursework, but still you have this thing in mind that finally at the end of the day, you have to work in this particular field, and anything extra that you're or any extra course that you're doing is just out of interest and is not going to really help you. And this is not the case in MSc, where you can take different electives without having any bias towards any particular subject. And this actually helps you make up your decision of the field in which you want to pursue your research career ahead. And this, I feel, is an important point. It is for this reason I feel MSc is actually a must. To be honest, in my opinion, no one really knows what field they like in their BSc, even at the end of their BSc, because there are just so many fields that if you know which field you want to work into, that just means that you haven't explored all and you have been focused in one direction till now. And it is the same case as in 12th, where most of the people opt for medical and engineering without even knowing the other options that they have. So it is similar to that. So unless you are very sure at the end of BSc that yes, I want to do astrophysics, or I want to do particle physics, or say nuclear physics, MSc feels like the correct path to me. So now let's come to the next point, which is one of the most important, that is fees. MSc is an educational approach. So you go there to gain knowledge. And of course, for that, the institute asks fees for it. So if you're doing an MSc, you will be paying fees to the institute where you're doing it, which is not the case in integrated PhD, because in integrated PhD, it is basically you have started working and started doing research. So you start getting stipend right after the third year of your BSc. And it is a very important point, especially for those who want to start earning and money is the priority. So to put things in perspective, in MSc, you continue spending money, and in integrated PhD, you start earning money. One way of getting out of this is looking up a college which offers granted seats in their MSc courses. So you end up spending much less. The next point is related to this point, which is one of the reasons, again, I was comfortable with MSc, is Inspire. If you have Inspire, then the load of fees is much less, as Inspire supports your 3 years of BSc as well as 2 years of MSc. If you switch to integrated PhD, you basically terminate your Inspire scholarship, which is about 60 to 80,000 per annum. But if you continue to do with MSc, you'll still be getting that Inspire scholarship. So that will take away the load of fees. So this is one of the major advantages of having Inspire scholarship. And that is the reason why we made a video about Inspire scholarship. You can find the link in the description. And we encourage you to pass on this information. You can forward this video to your school or junior college where you did your 11th and 12th, to your juniors or to your teachers, so that the next lot of people will be able to take advantage of this wonderful opportunity. Next point is again a straightforward point. MSc plus PhD takes about 2 plus 5, that is 7 years, and integrated PhD takes 6 years. So if you opt for integrated PhD, you get an advantage of 1 year. This is the case if you join a PhD of 5 years, if after MSc you think of going abroad, say you join a university in Europe or Australia where PhDs go on for like 3 and 3.5 years, so you actually end up getting a PhD even faster than integrated PhD just in 5 or 5.5 years. This was not a very important point for me at the time of decision because it didn't really matter if I give 1 year more or less, but I wanted to do my theory well and I wanted to explore more subjects and I wanted to learn more concepts. 1 or 2 years here and there don't really matter. What matters is that I get to learn good physics and do good research. The next point is a tad trivial one, which is, I would say, the type of life you will have. MSc is still a student life, so if you want to have college life, if you want to live student life for a few more years, then MSc is better. If you join integrated PhD, you are basically joining a work life. In integrated PhD, you start earning and you start doing research very quickly. So if you join MSc, you will get to enjoy more college life, and if you join integrated PhD, you would get to enjoy more office life. So in my case, I wanted to have student life because it is going to be work life later on anyway, and IIT B being one of the most happening campuses in India, I would get to see the best possible student life that is out there in India. The next point is a major one, which is regarding security. If you are getting an integrated PhD after a TYBSC, you don't really have to struggle from entrance point of view for the next 6 years. Like, you have entered an institute and you just have to do your work for 6 years. But it is not the case in MSc. If you choose MSc, after 2 years of MSc, you're back where you were when you were in TYBSC. And again, you have to give entrances like NET, GEST, etc. if you're applying in India. Or you have to apply, you have to make applications abroad and hope that you get selected. So if you have a bit of confidence that, no, even after doing MSc, I'm sure I will get selected somewhere in a place I like, then MSc is fine. But security-wise, integrated PhD is an obvious winner, so it's a bit risk-free. MSc comes with a risk. And to talk about my case, when I was in third year of my BSc, I had given INAT exam, which was conducted by IUCA and NCRA, which is a national level exam. And in third year BSc itself, I had cleared it as well as the 2 interview rounds. NCRA had given integrated PhD offer and IUCA had given pre-selection offer for a PhD. So I had an offer for PhD right in my third year of BSc itself. So it worked out well for me, which basically means you complete your MSc and join for a PhD. So, but that is if I want to continue in astro. But what if I didn't want to go in that stream? So my thinking at that point was, I knew MSc was just right for me because I wanted to explore more areas. I was not sure about the area, as well as I wanted to do more theory. I wanted to do more courses, so MSc was perfect for me. And I should follow what I feel is right for me. Also, if I have the worry whether I will get selected again in after 2 years of MSc, and in case I don't get selected, then I didn't really deserve the offers in the first place. So if I'm getting them now, I should be able to get them even after 2 years of MSc if I really deserve them. And that went fine with me because I cleared all the exams that I appeared in my MSc. Those were NET, CSIR NET, and TIFR. Managed to clear both of them, and I also applied and got selected at TIFR Mumbai. This one is related to alumni. If you do MSc plus PhD, you end up becoming alumnus of 2 institutes by the end of your PhD, whereas in case of integrated PhD, you become alumnus of 1 institute. This seems like a minor point, but it is actually a good point when it comes to institutes like IIT Bombay. That's where institute reputation matters a lot. IIT Bombay has a really good network of alumni. I'm talking about IIT Bombay because I know exactly about it, but this is true for any good reputation institute. They have strong alumni networks. For example, IIT Bombay alumni can always stay connected with IIT, as well as there are many events organized by IIT Bombay just for alumni in various different cities, not just in India, but also abroad like US. Then IIT Bombay has really good services. Like, if you want to begin a startup later on in your life, you can use facilities of IIT Bombay later on, and that will help you get started with a company later on if you want. And there are many more benefits like these. This is also the next point, which is institute reputation. So if there are 2 options, then institute reputation, of course, matters. If an institute is reputed or known worldwide, then you enjoy certain benefits later on in your life. So I guess this is the last point I have. And I hope I gave you some points. If I missed out any, if you have any extra points that you can think of, you may comment below. And I hope I answered the question of why I chose MSc at IITB over other integrated PhD offers. So that's it from me today. Thank you.